Welcome to this guide where I'm going to show you how you can install the Windows Subsystem for Android on Windows 10 and Windows 11. Now to get started, you're going to head to this webpage, which I'll also have included in my written guide, which will be the first link in this video's description. This is a GitHub page by MustardChef that has Windows Subsystem for Android builds that he developed. There's a lot of information that you should read through before you try and install this on your computer. And if you scroll down to the requirements part, you'll see that you'll need Windows 10 or Windows 11 to run on your computer. To prevent any issues, I recommend that you have the latest version of Windows 10 or Windows 11 installed with all of the latest available updates. You can also find some hardware requirements for the RAM, CPU, and graphics card. For the graphics, there are some additional notes for users with Intel HD graphics or users with NVIDIA graphics. Solid state drives are recommended, and this only works on NTFS partitions. And then lastly, in Windows features, you'll need to have the virtual machine platform enabled. These other three options are optional, and you'll also need to enable virtualization in your computer's BIOS settings. I've recently made a guide on how you can enable virtualization in Windows 10 or Windows 11, and I'll link that in the video's description and in the cards now. If you scroll even further down on this page, you'll see some additional sections. And if you're having any trouble installing this on your computer, you can come and have a look through any of these sections. There is also a section called Having Issues, which addresses some of the most common issues you might have when trying to install the Windows Subsystem for Android on your Windows 10 or Windows 11 computer. So to start, I'm going to scroll all the way up on this page until I find the Downloads page. And you need to choose a build depending on your operating system. For me, I have Windows 10. And I'm going to go with one of the latest stable builds, so I'll click on that. And here's also some additional information. Like I said, you need to read the guide in full before installing and make sure that you meet the requirements. One important note I'll just mention before we install the Windows Subsystem for Android is if you have the official Windows Subsystem for Android installed on your computer, you must completely uninstall it before you can use this version of the Windows Subsystem for Android. And I'm going to scroll all the way down until I find the download links. And here you can find a few download options. The main difference you'll find between all of these are that some have Google apps included in the package, some have Amazon included in the package, and some of them have both removed. I'm just going to choose this version, which has both Google apps and Amazon included. So I'll go ahead and click on this download link. And then we'll just wait for the download to finish, which is almost a gig in size. So once the file is finished downloading, I'm just going to go in and click on this little folder so I can see it in my downloads folder. Now right here I have this zip file which I'll need to extract, and I'm just going to go ahead and right click on that and then go to the 7-zip option and then extract it to the following folder. If you don't have 7-zip or any other file extraction software installed, just go ahead and download 7-zip, which is a free program. And I'll leave a link to this website in my written guide, which will be the first link in this video's description. So once it's finished extracting these files and I open this folder, I'll find another folder inside of this. And this folder has all of the files that we're looking for. So I'm just going to go ahead and rename this folder, and I'll only call it WSA. And then I'm going to take this WSA folder and I'm going to right click on it and then cut it to my C drive. And then I'll just paste it here. And then once I've done that, I'll open this folder, and then I want to find a file called run, which will be a Windows batch file. And I'm going to right click on this and then click on run as administrator. And this will start the Windows Subsystem for Android installation process. I've got a prompt asking if I want to enable optional diagnostic data. I'm just going to leave that box unchecked and then click on continue. And then the Windows Subsystem for Android will start installing. And now it looks like it's launched. It's Google Play is asking me to sign in. I'll go ahead and sign in. After entering all of my Google sign-in information, I've successfully got the Windows Subsystem for Android running on my Windows 10 computer. As you can see, I'm scrolling through the games here, and I can also go to the app section, and we can install anything here just to test. Let's install VLC as a test. And it successfully installed VLC, which I can open, and then VLC opens in Windows Subsystem for Android. So you can go ahead and install any games or any apps from the Play Store, as you'll now successfully have the Windows Subsystem for Android running on your Windows 10 or Windows 11 PC. I do hope this guide helps you out. Please like the video and see you in the next one.